Well, this is a story about three great questions. The first great question is, what is a human being? The second great question, is, how can a human being succeed with his life? And the third great question is, how can we help each other to succeed? Today is the 24th of July 2016, and it's a Sunday. And you know, the sun always knows how to be present on a Sunday. Well, not always, but today the sun certainly is present. And the forest which I'm biking in is the Danish very charming forest called the Hare Forest. The hare is not referring to the hare, the animal, but it's referring to a part on a lady, the part where a child can get out and be born. And I hope that during this pedal tour, maybe some kind of child can get out and be born. I would like to welcome you who is watching this video on YouTube, I guess, morning. And I'm very happy that you are with me, because I think this trip, this tic-tacking, talking, biking, I think this might be of some interest for anyone who has been giving this wonderful gift that it is to be having a life on this planet Earth among 7.4 billion other human beings. I also would like to tell you about a famous Danish poet called Benny Andersen. He has made a quite charming poem about the old Danish philosopher called Søren Kierkegaard, who in a dream meets Benny Andersen biking. Although the bike is not invented at the time of the philosopher Søren Kierkegaard, he do not care. He bikes, and he loves this biking, this Mr. Philosopher Søren Kierkegaard, because he says to the poem writer, the poet Benny Andersen, that this pedal, the repeat of the pedaling, is bringing him around and changing the perspective. So it leads the old philosopher to the conclusion that repeating something, that repetition is in fact making changes, and you don't have to be scared of a life where you are repeating something. If you, for instance, every morning stand up after being asleep, it could be interpreted as a boring part of your life, but it isn't, said this old Danish philosopher Søren Kierkegaard, it's a way to gain new understanding and new perspectives of your life. And I hope also, dear viewer, on this little video, I hope that you will follow me through these three great questions by this repeating of the pedals through this forest, this hair forest, preferring to conceive the way of conceiving the lay of life, being fruitful and making a way for new generations and new understandings. So please feel welcome and have a good seat wherever you are looking on this. I will now turn to the first great question, which is, what is a human being? Well, in the Christian tradition, you look upon a human being as a synthesis of two very different parts, namely the spirit and the flesh. The Mother Earth is contributing the flesh, and Father God is contributing the spirit, which in some interpretations is considered as a very small part of God himself, who he offers to become the upper part, the heavenly part of a human being, which allows the human being to stay in instantly contact with the Almighty, with its conceiver. And also the spirit is maybe the part in the English word human being that is considered as the being part. While talking about being, I think we should also mention William Shakespeare, the famous English writer of screenplays, and the one who is considered very famous here in Denmark, where it takes place in Elsinore on Kronborg, is the screenplay called Hamlet. And Hamlet has this wonderful question. Good morning. Good morning. And this wonderful question is, to be or not to be? And in my understanding, this refers to the spirit part of the human being, that is, to the being part, because you have to be aware of your goal in life to succeed. Well, that is the next great question. But talking still about the first great question, I would say that human being is a duality between flesh and spirit, and it through its life becomes a trinity, because to negotiate and to find a way together, the flesh and the spirit generates a room of dialogue, which in some traditions is called the psyche, the mind, the soul, and sometimes also the personality. The whole personality is also used, I believe, to include the three parts of the person. It means the spirit, the soul, and the flesh. And in Christian tradition, we have St. Paul writing in a letter to the Thessalonica, first Christian people, that he hoped for them that they will be able to maintain these three parts, their spirit, their soul, and their body, intact and in good shape, so that they can raise with Jesus Christ when he will return, and a new era is supposed to begin. So, to answer the first great question, I would say that a human being is basically a duality of two components called spirit and flesh, and later it becomes a trinity containing the three parts, spirit, soul, and body. So now I'll go to the next great question, which is, how can a human being succeed with his life? Right now, God has given a little part of his divinity to about 7.4 billion world citizen living all around the planet Earth. And it is my assumption that giving a little part of his of himself, maybe so to speak, he has also given a purpose of life to each of our 7.4 billion population, which also counts you who is looking at this little video essay, and also me who is biking and pedaling to get somewhere in understanding. And the way that a human being can succeed in his life is basically to identify and to realize this purpose in his life that has been given it by God, and who is present in its inner voice as an understanding. Well, how can a human being get to know what is God's will, what is God's meaning of the life of this particular human being? How can you find out what is the meaning of me, as a great Danish philosopher Søren Kierkegaard asks, when I am tired of investigating myself, I pass time, have a cigar, and ask God, ask myself, what has God thought that I should do in this life? What is the meaning of me? And this is, of course, a very great question, the second of the three which I'm working on this tour. So there is many ways to find out, because God has not put on a silver medallion around your neck written what is the purpose of your life. You don't have it that clear. You have to work upon it and find out and ask within yourself. And you can ask someone, maybe you can ask your conscience. In Danish, conscience is called samvittighed, and in Swedish it's called samveta. And if you translate this into English, it means that it's common knowledge. And so please try and understand your consciousness as common knowledge. And then we could ask, who is the person who is coming? Common about this knowledge, and what is the knowledge that they are common about? Well, I think that the persons involved is the person with the consciousness and the Almighty, or maybe a represent from the Almighty. And what they are knowing in common is what is the purpose of the person's life who has this consciousness. And this is a way that you can get in contact. Also, if you do succeed and you go up to heaven and you have the last big examine towards God on a big green table, you sit and God says, well, little creation of mine, how do you think you went through your life according to your own opinion? And then it's happy. Then you are happy if you can say, well, I think I found out what your purpose was with me, and I was lucky that I found out so early that I had still some power in my body, so I had the strength to realize it. Well, God the Almighty says, it sounds good, but did you also find out that I have sent a helping force to you so that you could get information about anything necessary going through your life and your challenge? Morning. Yes, happily, if so, you can say, yes, I found out, and of course I brought this wonderful helper with me. He's sitting right, or her, beside me to join this examination, because he is very much in honor that this has been a success. And then God the Almighty asks the helper sitting next to his creation, well, do you agree that my creation here did actually get in contact with you and did actually use your help and your company and became a team together with you to succeed with his life? And then the angel says, because this helper is an angel, it's also called a special angel, it's called a guardian angel, which the Almighty have given maybe to all of his 7.4 billion human being creations, world citizens on this planet Earth, they have all got their own personal guardian angel. It's an exciting thought. No one can know, but I personally like this thought. And then God the Almighty asked the guardian angel, do you agree? Did my creation, did he really succeed in making a team out of the two of you and working together with you as a talker and he as a walker? And the angel says, yes, and it has been a great joy for me to be guardian angel for this creation of yours, dear God. He all the time knew to turn to you, O God, or to me, the guardian angel, when he got into trouble and he got confused about what direction his life should take. And it was a really pleasure to be his friend and his helper. And I would almost say that it has been a marvelous experience, and I'm so thankful that you, God, gave me this creature to be guardian angel for, and because he has succeeded with his life, my life as a human, my life as a guardian angel has also been a success. Now I will turn to the third great question, which is, how can we help each other to succeed? And I will first say, as an understanding that I've met quite a few times and which I very much agree in, is that basically we're here to help each other. It is said by Christ that you should love your God unconditionally, and also you should love your neighbor, whoever he might be and whoever you might get to know him or meet him. And of course, in this connection, hospitality is a very vital value. And I have this summer been what I call a hotel director on a very small hotel with only two rooms at stake. And I have had many, many travelers as guests through this summer. I've had these two rooms occupied 100% all the time, and it has been a wonderful experience for me to get in contact with so many people from all around the world. And of course, you might ask if this was due to this organization or a web system called Airbnb, and I can assure you that this would never have been possible if not for this great idea and this great web information and booking facility. So I think that the worldwide hospitality is a very old quality in the culture of humanity. And I think that humanity is a nice word, because in some way you could say that humanity is in fact the 7.4 billion human beings and world citizens. I would now introduce Abraham Maslow, an American psychologist, who had said that what a man can be, he must be. And Greek philosopher Aristotle says that where your talent cross the need of the world lies your vocation. I think it's the same as meaning of life when you and what I'm speaking of, the purpose of life determined by God, that you have to find out about this to succeed with life. And Abraham Maslow has this hierarchy of needs, where the lowest part is red, it's the physical needs, it's food, and it's sleeping, and it's making family and children and so on. And this is the basic needs. And in top there's a blue triangle talking about the actualization of each and every human being. And I think that maybe the best way that we can help each other is to make poverty history, and to eliminate hunger. And my dream, which might be my purpose of life, is that the World Bank and the United Nations will create a world citizen account for each of the 7.4 human beings, and this account will be receiving $1 a day, because in this way everyone on this wonderful planet Earth will have a fair chance to get into a day where you also get a chance to search and to try to find out your purpose of life, instead of just being busy trying to find something to eat, which easily can take a whole day. And easily can take a whole day, yes, if you are not helped in a little way about having a easy way to get your basic needs, to get this basic needs satisfied. Now I have reached the church where I am working. It's a church in the Holy Evangelic Lutheran Danish People's Church, and I'm very happy to be involved in this church. Of course, you have to work also in a church. It's not just a nice time all the times, but in spite of the factories and companies out in the society, where you're just heading for for satisfying the stakeholders in the church, you also are involved to satisfy the spiritual and the social aspects of your stakeholders, and that I think is very charming and lifting up. So I have in this work a very very satisfying and sometimes even loving everyday life. Now I will like to thank you who has been with me on this trip through the three great questions and through the Hare Forest. I'd like to thank you that you have followed me so far, and I hope that we'll meet someday. And I would like to wish you a nice day and a wise life, and I hope that you will get in contact if you have not already become that to your guardian angel, and this way find out what is your purpose, what is your goal in life. And I hope, I wish for you that you will succeed, and if I can do anything to help you, please contact me. I would love to help you if I can. Thank you.